I said it's running in Unreal 4, so it's gonna look good. Press launch, says Rambus.
I'm afraid the worst has happened. Operation Global Remedy has failed, and we are looking at a mass depletion of the Earth's resources.
Should we engage on our final backup plan?
This astronaut is the only chance humanity has left for survival.
Are you aware this is a do-or-die mission? Once we launch, there's no turning back.
We have no choice. All mankind depends on it. Please, deliver us the moon. Deliver us.
Please. Deliver us. Please. Deliver us.
Deliver us the moon. How much? Ah! Hey! 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 We're a jumping machine! How much is the fish? Oh dear, humanity is bollocks then! Please don't let the astronaut be charred! Yeah, don't let that happen. So yeah, so it's got third person like this. You always have first person. You can use the mouse wheel to scroll in and out. And if you scroll in all the way in, you get first person. But it's Unreal 4, so it's, you know, the engine is very stable, right? Around. Oh, there's a phone. I think you start out I've just run around the station a little bit when I played it earlier, just to see what it performed like. So I've not left this building that we start in yet. I just ran around this one room. Yeah, I mean, at the moment we're still we're on Earth still. We haven't actually got to space yet. And I said this is an early alpha demo build. I don't know how much content's in here. It's probably not a great deal. It's just to show, I think it's just to show off some of the base mechanics that they've got already. And I said the Kickstarter kicks off on the 1st of February. Ah, okay. WSA. Okay. No room to fap in? Ah, it's the rocket. Okay, so we're actually starting in Kazakhstan, and we're gonna take the rocket up towards the moon, I guess. Or we're gonna go to directly to the moon. Maybe we'll go to a station or something on the way. Look around. This big, like, space, like, base here in the middle of nowhere in the desert in Kazakhstan. Well. Isn't that the big like mission control, right? No one there, that's kind of troubling. There's no one at mission control. I mean, he runs pretty quickly in this suit, doesn't he? Huh. I guess we're heading to the rocket. And we're gonna do the unthinkable. We're gonna launch. Maybe we're gonna sort of move. Yeah, I do like the light and the sun rays. It's very well done. So we got a lift, or we can take the stairs. Should we take the stairs, or should we take the lift? Let's take the lift. One giant step. Again, guess it's been all sorts of interior mission controls that are maybe. Okay, we're getting in the rocket. Whoa. Rockets. Quick startup guide. Start each event with caution. The wrong button will cause the full system shutdown. There are two phases. Ground phase, 7 stages, and air phase, 3 stages. Complete all 10 stages to arrive at a space station. Okay, so Start the crown launch sequencer. Okay. Oh, okay. I guess these crown launch sequencer. I guess it looks like the red buttons are ones we can actually select. There it. Okay, crown launch sequencer. The Earth to Mars. Retract to orbiter arm. I think it's down here. There it is. Okay. Start auxiliary power units. Retract gaseous oxygen vent arm. I know it's down here. Yes. Activate sound suppression system. Activate hydrogen burn-off system. Let's do this. The engine start. Whoa! We're off. We are off. Who needs the retractor arm beam? That was a quick in. We are rocketing up to the atmosphere now, I guess. We look out the window. Maybe we're going to see. Just watch the clouds, see if we can see when it's starts to get closer to the atmosphere into space. You can see it's getting darker. Right? It's getting darker, it's getting darker. Here we go. Whoa, look. Ah, okay. You didn't do the countdown. Looks like late 60 space tech. There was no countdown, I'm sorry. I didn't know it was going to take off as soon as we hit that button. Alright, engine cut off. Ah, blue problems, okay. Stage separation. Engage second stage ignition. So the red stuff is what you push on the first phase, and the blue stuff on the second phase. Well, you don't know. I mean, you're just looking from inside. It took off quite quickly, didn't it? I think this the rocket taking off and getting to the station is probably like a transitionary event, rather than just having a load screen. They just get you to go there, if you know what I mean. Rather than some like a big part of the game. That's what I reckon. It's probably a transition thing, just to make it feel like you're going to the station, rather than having to worry about just having a load screen with a rocket moving or something. Right, oxygen breach. Okay. No oxygen. Oh shit, Lonnie's back. He's got the timer. I guess that's the amount of time we got for our oxygen to run out, I guess. So when that number hits zero on his back, is the oxygen going to be gone then, I guess? Level up! Let's go this way first. Hey, Hammerock. International Space Hub. Oxygen breach. Oh. Wow, I got 20 seconds of oxygen out of that. Okay. We got 52 seconds. But yeah, if you look in here, obviously, we're... The gravity feels good. It feels like there's some weight on the jumps and that, which is pretty good. Obviously, he's got his suit on and his big heavy old boots, right? It does look good. And we got to remember, right? This is an early alpha build of the game. The game isn't even, we haven't even got to the Kickstarter launch is next month, so it is early off. I think they've kind of got this demo ready for press to kind of get a bit of awareness out there for what the game is before they launch their Kickstarter. That's how I'm kind of seeing it. No, it's not. That was something else. This is something that's brand new. Hammerock. It's called Deliver Us to the Moon. It's made by some Dutch developers, Dutch indie devs. And where is it? Is it oxygen? Oh, look, there's the Earth. Dutch Dutch indie studio, and it's going into Kickstarter next month. Come on, 47 seconds left. We've got plenty of time, right? Oh, shit. The sound, I like the sound sphere, atmospheric music, the sound effects are really good. Whoa, elevator. Yeah, I know which game you mean. I can't quite remember the Reverse Side. That was the game you mentioned. That's the game you're referring to, Hammerock. That was kind of by some Russian devs. It's never been finished. They've not really done any updates since I played it. Okay, so we're in the station now. If you look, the number on our back has stopped. So I guess we got oxygen here. F for flashlight. Okay. It looks similar, but is it with aliens? I don't know, Wyborg. I honestly don't know. Basically the whole idea of the aim of the game is you're a lone astronaut. You've been sent up to the moon from Earth, and you're on a mission to deliver. It's called Deliver Us the Moon. It says you need to deliver the moon to save mankind. What they mean by deliver the moon, I have no idea. But it's like a story-based game. Elevators are always bad, especially on the space station. Link? You want a link to this? Is that what you were looking for? I think deliver us to... Oh, let me just... One sec. Let me just give you the link that I have. The easiest place to have a look at it. If you... I should have put it on the bot command. They are on... They do have a... Greenlight page up. Yeah, where is it? There's my notepad. Okay. I saved the links in a notepad file. Come on. Info on it. That's the green light page, PG2. I mean, the other link is their main homepage, which is, it's got a lot of info on there. I think it's got more info on there. In case of emergency, a blind high voltage will cause the doors to open. Okay. And it's got a bit more information on their homepage about who they are and the devs. I mean, I've never been on a space station, but it looks pretty cool. What is that? Use the right button to aim? Oh, what the fuck is this? It's some sort of like laser gun or something. Look at it. Ready? What is it? What? I mean, shooting doesn't... If I hit the left button, it doesn't shoot. Hang on. Oh, okay. So this is like a... It's probably gonna... Okay, so you said in here, like, applying high voltage will cause the doors to open. So if I hold the right button to aim on this, and then left button, okay. So you're shooting like a energy pulse that, or to kind of open up the doors, I guess, right? This space station's a bit deserted, isn't it? There's no one here, or no one on, nothing here. This green light's a bit bright. Jeez. It's a BFG! Flashlight. Forget the flashlight. You know what? This flashlight's actually pretty good, isn't it? It's just like a little storage room. There's nothing actually in here, though. I think this is the sort of flashlight that I reckon our buddy Jim Sterling would like, that actually lights up an area rather than just a little circle in front of your face. Hey, Chris Animal. The music is very atmospheric, this music. Wait, he's leaving. It is. Okay. So we're leaving the footprints. Okay. I wasn't sure for a second. We're leaving footprints everywhere. You could draw your name in footprints, maybe. What is that? Down. That door's locked. I guess maybe we've got to do something down the bottom to maybe open this up. Maybe. Hey, Geordie. Yes. It's looking very good. I mean, I checked it out a little bit earlier. I played it just a little bit on when we're on Earth, and I figured this is really good. I gotta stream some of this, and I've just been saying I really like it. Okay, let me just go on the other side first. It looks very, very good. I mean, Unreal Engine itself is really, really a good-looking engine, but it's put together really well already. You know, in the early build that we have. I'm not sure what the hell we're doing, but you know, just experiment as you go, right? What is that? What is that? So press Q to switch on. Oh, what the? He's got a big ball on his back. What is that? I don't know what that is. Oh, we'll take it. Oh, music's building up a little bit. And we've got a power button here, and two things here we can shoot, so I guess this is not going to do it. We've got to power it up first, I guess, right? And can we go up here first? Activate your ass! Your ASE! ASE, yeah. Oh, that's the ball we got on our back, okay. Put a droid on a pedestal lifted. Okay. Does that mean we've got to put it on here? Ah, okay. Pedestal lifted. So this thing should have the first two things marked as green, right? Once that goes up. Ah, there we go, look. First power pole activated. So you've got to activate the three power poles. With the, this thing, okay. Yeah, okay. That's one. This is gonna be like a little droid or something that's gonna like an AI or something maybe? That'd be cool. Wait, let's go to the control room. You can say AS. ass, ace. Ah, here we go. Activate procedure. Let's do it. Are we kind of bringing life to a droid here or something? So that's what it's thinking like. And someone mentioned GLaDOS in chat. Exactly. I'm blowing the shit out of the station. This is, Oh, it's activated. Okay. I don't get it. Ah, shit, yes. Hang on. Is that friendly? I guess it is, right? Hey. Hello, mate. She's following me around. I can't interact with her, but it's following me, so... Hi. Can we pet it? It looks pretty cool. I like the movement on that guy. On that little guy. I mean, look at it. The way he's moving around and following you around is really cool. The little jets on him. Holy shit. He even like flew into the floor. What? Now, let's do that again. You can tell he's new at his job. He keeps flying into things. Oh, maybe we gotta take this guy upstairs, maybe to open that door. Oh, what's he doing? Is that robot the reason we found no humans on the station? Did it push a ball out of an airlock? Who knows? I gotta make sure I don't go too close to an airlock, because he might come and push us out. Where'd he go? What is it, Lewis? What? I like him. He looks pretty cool. I like how the weapons. I mean, you got obviously we switched to this gun to this thing. How he stows them on his back is really good. Hey, KeokeN. Now this is a familiar game. I wonder what. Yeah, so I think we was getting a bit too far away from him, and he pulled it to us, I think. Let's see if we can outrun him. Oh shit, there's another door here I can open. Come on, Ace! We're gonna find monsters or something. He gets really close, doesn't he? I really like the soundscape in this game, which I said a bit earlier. I really like the soundscape. It's really, really good. Shouldn't he be going in front rather than hiding behind me like a little kid? I mean, he's just standing behind you like a kid. Ah, we got... Okay, we're making him... Okay, he's fixing stuff, okay, I guess. Ah, he's fixing the elevator. Is that an elevator? Or is that just a doorway? Let's look up here first. Ah, it's the Earth! I keep thinking I'm gonna trip over this little thing. Look at that. That was cool. A good space. It looks good, doesn't it? I mean, I do like the movement on the character as well, and it feels very good. I mean, like the movement, the jumping, it feels good. Like, when you're looking at the movement of his arms when he's jumping and stuff, it's animated very well. That mate, can you fix it? Stats, auditory monitors are turned on. I've just got stats. Stats. Right, let's go and look in the other room. I mean, so in a moment, obviously, because we're on a space station at the moment, and I guess the objective here is you've got to get to the moon. I know, as far as this build we're in now, I know the moon isn't here in this demo build. I don't know how much, you know, how... Oh, shit. Nice. I don't know how much there is of this, but what's here is very good so far. As something, as like a short, like alpha-based demo, just to show people what the game, show people what the game is like and what it's capable of. It seems very, very. What's here is very, very good. Oh, there's like little buggies. We've only got 30 seconds, man. Is there some oxygen here somewhere? I can pick up. There we go. Outside. Let's. Yeah, before Bud dies in 20 seconds. Ah, we exited. That's. Holy shit. So, okay, so that was the extent of the demo. So, when you. Just as you leave the station, but. I don't know. I don't know about you guys, but. Let's just say I'm impressed with what I've seen so far. Damn. That's really good. It's a very good experience. I mean, it's only like a short demo at the moment, but can you imagine what this is going to turn into? I don't know. I mean, you guys are in a good, Jordy and like KeokeN, in chat. I mean, just I got just one question. I mean, you got the Kickstarter's kicking off on February the 1st. I mean, have you guys got an idea of how long you want the campaign to last? I mean, is it going to be like something that's going to be like, you know, 10, 12 hours? Have you got a ballpark figure of how long it's going to be, or is that still something that's being worked on as you're doing the development? Just curious if you had like an idea of how much, you know, a rough idea of how long you was going to have the experience last once in your head. Of course, once it's finished during development, anything you say now could well change. But I'm just curious if it's, you know, how long you were kind of wanting the campaign to be. You got it largely mapped out, okay? Yeah, it's. It does look very good. Not rather, the visuals are very good. I mean, the station looks really impressive. I mean, and like the feel of the character feels very good. But the soundscape, yes, the soundscape in the game is really good. And props to the musician, the guy that did the music for it, because it's very atmospheric and it feels it works. Development is crazy. I can imagine, because you guys are you're a small dev team. I think I was reading on the website, there's like about, or on the Steam page, there's like 10 of you, I believe, or somewhere around there. So it's not a lot of you. And it looks like it's kind of a new studio as well. I mean, is this like the first game you guys have done on PC? Out of curiosity? Captain Richard will be happy. You can stare at his buttocks. He'll be happy about that. But just the movement on the character is really, really good. Just looking at the animations of him, you know, it's very, very well done. You'd like to be topped off with oxygen before the gate opens, so you can enjoy the moment of the gate opening, without having to run out of oxygen. I nearly did, yes. He's gonna flip out when he hears about this. Your audio guy's great. Yes, he is. He really is. Honestly, I mean, even just the sound effects. But the music, I really love the music. It fits very well into the type of atmosphere and type of environment that you guys are portraying in the game. It feels very good. But even like the sound effects for like the lifts and stuff, it's, you know, die and see what happens. Well, yeah, we'll go back up there and we'll run out of oxygen while we're in the space station part. We'll just dance and just see a death animation. Zombies, those arcs start off small, and look how big they got. Yes, definitely. I mean, I'd not really heard about this title until last week, and I think it was that Jesse was guy I know through Twitter. I kind of had some dealings with Jesse. He's someone I follow. Kind of get some press stuff from him, and he mentioned this title, and I looked into it a bit more after you mentioned it, and it's like, okay, this is just up my street, because I'm a big supporter of indie games, but also we're a big sci-fi community. We love sci-fi games, you know, not just indie, just all anything sci-fi we love. And come on, maybe I should have took the elevator. I just want to see even here, as you're running up the stairs, the sound of the wind blowing through the frames. This, I think it was good. You got a big surprise going on in the Kickstarter. I can believe that. All right, so it's God, where they are? Damn it! All right, orbit access arm, auxiliary power units, gaseous vent. Ah, shit! I did it too quick. Damn it! Take it slow. No rushing. You can't rush into space. Looks like a 60s pickup, but he's back. Yes. Yeah, that's a good idea, actually. I mean, when was he before? I think PGC Moore, one of the regulars here, kind of mentioned that the cockpit of the rocket looks very 60s. I mean, is it what sort of era is it based in? Is it based around the 60s and 70s? It does say on the Steam page that they're looking at Rift support, Rambos, yes. So on the Steam page, it lists the green light page. They're listing that it's looking to have a BVR and Rift compatible. Can we please have a voice giving us a countdown until liftoff? It would be pretty cool with a Rift, right? I mean, you can just imagine just sitting in this rocket here as you're taking off, doing these sequences, and having it in VR. Kimball would be very happy, yes. Yeah, I reckon a countdown maybe something that I can see being in later on, though. I mean, it definitely would help. Well, it definitely would help with, we obviously watch, I don't think any of us here are astronauts, but we, you know, you watch the rocket take
friendly contact approved.
KeokeN Interactive, thank you. We hear that we watch the rocket take off on TV. You get the countdown, and it's all very good. It would be useful to be there. Be there later. VR and track IR, yes, track IR would be good. I think track IR is probably easier to easier to get done, because it's something that's out there now, isn't it? And I've got a track IR, so that would be cool. That would be cool, because I had one of those. And hello, Vandal. Yeah, it's a pretty neat looking game, Vandal. It's early alpha demo of a title that's kicking off in Kickstarter next month. But I want to see what happened when you... See what happened when we ran out of oxygen. So... We are going to run out of oxygen and just see. 100 years exactly after the Apollo moon landing. Ah, okay. Set in the near future. Let's walk around. All very casually, because we know we're safe. Just time is slowly ticking down. We're just casually walking through the station. We can't see our face in the helmet. Not the smoke. The smoke mist is pretty cool. But Unreal does effects like this. Unreal does very, very good. The Unreal Engine with like smoke and stuff like this is always very good. Say hello to finding Seven. Long story short, Earth's running out of resources, and you are Earth's last hope, a rogue astronaut hoping to save the world on a desolate planet, which should be so familiar, but yet isn't in so many ways. Oh, time's running out. Hey, Jim. Death of a spaceman. Time's running out. Let's just go stare at the Earth as we inevitably demise. Nice, ten. It's time to flicker and flash. Is something bad gonna happen? The reflection on the helmet's good as well. I just noticed that. The helmet reflection. That's actually... The helmet reflection is actually accurate as well. That's pretty good. I mean, that's something that's, I think a lot of people overlook. Uh-oh. Ugh. There you go, Rambos. We died. We died, Rambos. Yeah. I want to see what happened when it ran out. Because, you know, stuff and things. You gotta try. You gotta see what happens when it runs out. No. Whoa.
Exterminate!
Oh, you can actually. That's kind of a bit. That's probably something that's a bug. That's a bug, man. Oh, what the hell is that? But yeah, I was saying the oxygen's just there. It's just there. Can we try to grab it? We can grab it. We can put our head near it. Like his arm's nearly there. Yeah, I wanted to see what happened when you died. All right. To happen when you died, but yeah, it is really good for what it is so far. And as I said, it's early build. It looks very good. It looks very, very good. He's got a couple of different deaths. I just seen him just go, just veg out and collapse. Nice ragdoll death. Yeah, I want to can we? Let's just get up there now. I want to get back up there and mess with that robot a little bit. Nah, no worries. I'd like to try this. The game actually launches in Kickstarter on February the 1st. Gemma? I think they've KeokeN have been very kind enough to. They kind of given some YouTubers, some Twitch streamers, some press access to this early kind of alpha build, alpha demo, just to kind of check the game out, get a bit of word out about the project. I mean, I can honestly say I'd not heard of it until it was mentioned to me a few days ago, or just before the weekend. So trying to get a bit of raise a bit of awareness for the project before the Kickstarter kicks off. And which is the 1st of February. I know I will be definitely going to be looking forward to it. I'm looking out for it. Yes, the Dutch, yes. You've been sucked by Nikki to play Armored Warfare. I've not. I mean, I know some people that have been playing that, but I've not played it myself, Pappy.
Friendly contact approved.
A Geordie of LS squared. Hydrogen burn off system. Adjoins. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, three, two, one. We are ignition. Boom. happening?
We did a sort of...
FIBO is the shit, so good. Food from a woman is such a cool concept. Oh.
Good for late night partying. Which I think you Dutch guys are kind of definitely known for your partying. It's been a while since I was in Holland. I've not been over there for quite a few years. I got a buddy that lives in Rotterdam. I think they just say kind of hint of vehicles. So what I want to try and do is get towards the end part where it ended. But before we go out, have a look at that room, because it looked like there was a moon buggy in that room, or like part of a moon buggy. Because it looked like you saw like the shell of like a buggy, a moon buggy. I don't know if that's what it was intended to be, or that's the start of a vehicle or something you're putting together.
You just described it. You need it in my library. Good.
Gemma. I kind of figured when I saw it that this is going to be something that you guys would like, because you know we're into space games. We like exploration games.
You're just teasing.
It's trying to have a look at that thing properly. Then. So yeah. So to do this properly now, of course, you've got this section here is there's no oxygen. So you got a counter on your back that's ticking down, which is the amount of seconds until you run out of oxygen and die. So we've got to get into the main part of the station before we run out of oxygen. And we're going to get, there's an oxygen up here. I think it's up here, a container up here that gives us a little bit more time. You know, you get to explore. We saw this earlier on. I like to explore. You get like 20 seconds with one of these. I like the timer on his back though. That's a very nice touch. You know, rather than having like a timer counting down on the screen somewhere. I mean, it's very minimalist, the UI, and it's, you know, I like it. I mean, it's a very nice touch, as I said, having it on his back like that. So if you're in first person and you play the game fully in first person, obviously you may not see that. You know, you may not see that. Was there another one up here? I don't think there was. Well, you look here though. It looks like here you got this ball here. And when I saw this earlier on, I wasn't sure what this is, but I'm wondering if that's kind of another one of those robots just laying there. Those little AIs. Maybe so, Doug. Yes. But having that sort of minimalist UI is really cool. It kind of, especially if it's going to be going, if it does go like the VR route in the future, if you get like Rift support in during development, it's going to make it immerse yourself a lot more by not having to worry about, looking at text on the screen, if you know what I mean. Alright, so we've still got plenty of time. What? We just got to go in here. We got this. Yeah, I can imagine it being very, very good looking in Rift, in any sort of VR experience. Because I mean, at the moment, the way the oxygen's running down, you know, even if you, as long as you're not walking, if you're running, as long as you're not walking, you've got plenty of time to get to where you need to go. All right. like the model of this like weapon or this. I don't know especially if it's intended as a weapon, but it looks pretty it's a very chunky little thing, isn't it? Rather than looking like a conventional gun, which is it's like Rambo now. Just running around like a crazy looking shooting. Sort of horror, are there horror Gemma says, are there horror elements in this game? I don't know, that's kinda curious. That's kinda curious question there, Gemma. Is there going to be horror elements? Because you could definitely see it fitting in very well. I mean, you know, if you think about like games like Alien Isolation, you can definitely see that sort of thing being fitting in very well. Oh, look, there's one of those, it's like a baby one of those little things. You'd think buttons and levers would be a better way to open doors. Maybe. Maybe it's a security thing. The avatars. Maybe it's a security thing. Possibly. They got a big ball on their back. Powered up. It's quite plausible you might end up fighting enemies later on. Ah, cool. Look at it. That's cool. I do like my exploration type games. Even if there wasn't an enemy, it was just you exploring the landscape, trying to find, trying to find a way to save mankind. That would definitely be my thing. Obviously, enemies just make. Just add things, add to it a little bit, right? There he is.
Should play the music "Fly Me to the Moon," Frank Sinatra. Doesn't get more American than that. Big balls, big guns. Whoa. I can't shoot him in the face.
I guess. Technically, it's not really a gun, so. I like the fact he just keeps flying into shit. He's like a little drunk robot. He's like, keeps flying into stuff, then teleporting close to you. His awareness is a little bit lacking, right? Go on, if you run around the corner quickly and just. If a rogue astronaut, then it's fair to assume that maybe a rogue astronaut's trying to stop you. Maybe. In the story, lots of countries had sent astronauts to the moon to find a possible solution for mankind's looming extinction. Yeah, so I suppose if there's there could be other people up here, I suppose. Okay, let's go check out this vehicle prototype. Come on, buddy, get on there, fix it up. In these bases, you'll discover what all the countries were researching by. So we got this this little. It looks like the base of a buggy of some type. A little here. could be doing like building like a lunar rover or something in this room, or these are like parts of them. Extend our life for another 20 seconds. I just think you can just... Shez. You can just refill this thing indefinitely and just walk around and have a look around. Cool. I kind of wonder though, you can hear, right? And it's like... you got the blue... These blue rays here. I don't know what they are. We're doing our best to make a good game. Yeah, from what we see so far is really... I'm really impressed by what we see so far. So, for example, I want to see Bode run out of oxygen while he's jumping. I guess we can try that. Are we supposed to be jumping up on top of stuff? I don't know. You gotta explore, right? Yeah, obviously there's no oxygen here, and you can definitely feel the weight on the character when you're jumping somewhere like this. Like, that's a good place to jump from, right? When we get down to zero, we can jump off of there. As far as the demo is concerned, I mean, is it like an alpha demo, Gemma? As you walk out this door, the demo ends. So the demo will end as we walk out of this door. I wanted to come and look at these buggies again, because these are like a potential vehicles in the making here. Hey, little Dermuff.
It's a long time left, crazy animal.
Only available for reviewing purposes. Yes. And it's just a demo just to get like some press to raise awareness of the actual game in the run up to the Kickstarter. And that's how I'm kind of picturing it. Because the Kickstarter kicks off in a couple of weeks on February the 1st, and seems like it's their way of getting more awareness out there. Because once you see some YouTubers playing it and some magazines and writing articles about it and some streamers like myself playing it, people, I mean, like a bunch of you guys in chat, you know, I would imagine hadn't heard of this before, and it's kind of, anyone it's kind of bringing knowledge of the project to is going to help, right?